So what does that mean to me?
I just told you.
What does that mean?
No, it's on the camera, don't worry. It's on the camera. The camera will
What does that mean?
Now I'm asking you, what does it mean?
Zag, help me.
Admit that you don't know.
Zachariah, help me.
Let me, I'm giving you the opportunity, you're on camera, to show yourself intelligent. Show yourself intelligent and answer the question.
Listen to me, finish the talking. We believe any verse here that agrees with the Quran, we take it.
There you go. He does right.
I agree with you that in free, Jesus is saying that God is a true God.
I'm agreeing with you. There's not a disagreement. But what you like to do is you stop there. So I want you to answer me this, Lamin.
I finished the work which thou hast given me to do. And now, O Father, where are you going? Where are you going? Okay, I'll speak to the people. Right.
And now, O Father, glorify thy... Here, this is what Jesus is saying. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. Question. How was Jesus with God? How was Jesus with the Father before the world was? Answer my question. Don't use the camera as an excuse. Answer my question. Lamin liked the verse where he said, the only true God whom you have sent. Jesus goes on to say,
he's making it look like you're winning.
They've won. They've won. They've run.
Tell your friend to move the camera and then bring the debate back.
No, but they ran though, bro.
They run.
They ran though.
With the camera.
Did I call him? I didn't call him. That's not an excuse. My friend, that's not an excuse. Right. So Jesus said he was with the Father. How was he with the Father before the world began? But let's go back. Let's go back to all the verses, yeah? Because this is the bit. Now look what's going on here. You're using the very bit to try and say Jesus is not God. But every single verse from 17:1, look, this is Jesus saying he's God. These words make Jesus and lifted up his eyes to heaven. Father, the hour is come, glorify thy Son. So Jesus is already saying, Lamin, are you listening? Jesus is already saying that God is Jesus is already saying that he's God's son. Jesus is already saying that he's God's son. Verse 2. So verse 1, Jesus said that he's God's son. Let's go to verse 2. As thou hast given him power over all flesh. Jesus has power over all flesh. Jesus is just a prophet. Tell me the name of another prophet that has power over all flesh. Give me the name of a prophet.
Only one name.
Give me the name of a prophet.
Only one name, and I think I should highlight right now.
Moses, Abraham, David, do they have power over all flesh?
Only one name.
So verse 1, Jesus said he's the son of God. Verse 2, he said that he has power over all flesh. Yes? And this is eternal life, that they may know thee. So this is the context now. The verse that Lamin likes to take out of context. It sounds good when you stop there. And this is eternal life, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom thou hast sent. First of all, I want to deal with that verse. It's called a sentence connector. When it says, and this is eternal life, that they might know thee, the only true God, the Jesus Christ is referring to what he said before, the only true God. So the Jesus Christ is called a sentence connector. It's called the Granville Sharp rule. It's called a sentence connector. So when it says, the only true God is referring to the Jesus Christ that comes after it. And the Jesus Christ that comes after it is referring to the God. And then next verse, I have glorified thee on the earth. What other prophet? Give me the name of another prophet that's been glorified. Give me the name of another prophet that's been glorified. Nobody is to receive glory but God. Nobody is to receive glory but God.
Jesus is God.
Can you answer?
Case closed, Rabin. Don't debate Christians, Rabin.
People, we were made differently so we can know each other and speak to each other and understand one each other.
That's right. Are you understanding me so far?
If you disagree with Islam, and we disagree with the Christianity, that's just all right.
No, that's fine.
You have your religion.
No, I agree with that.
But the way you're shouting, that's not the way.
No, my friend, I'm not shouting. This is Speaker's Corner. You must understand Speaker's Corner. I'm not only speaking to you two, I'm speaking for everybody here. So I'm not shouting at you. I'm shouting so that people can speak. This is the nature of Speaker's Corner. Speaker's Corner. Nobody shouts louder than another.
Say away to me, you have made another God.
Nobody shouts.
You're good.
Yeah. Nobody shouts louder than Lamin, but the difference is he shouts, say nothing.
You're good.
He's not saying anything when he's shouting.
Okay, listen.
Talks a lot, says nothing.
You have made another god to me.
Okay, I understand. Are you a Muslim, sir?
I'm a Muslim.
Are you Muslim? Okay.
You have made another god because our god is unseen. We believe in unseen.
My god is unseen.
Your god is not unseen if it's Jesus.
No, 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 hold on. Let me explain that. God is invisible and God is unseen. And again, I'm not shouting at you. I'm talking about everybody's speaking. God is invisible and God is unseen. God, who is invisible and unseen and eternal, has taken a human body. And that's who Jesus is. It says, in the God was Jesus.
So God has taken the human body to come here on earth.
Yes, that's what he's done. So let's be clear.
Then again, it's not unseen. You've seen the God, right?
God in flesh, yes. But let's
you've
be clear. Let's get this started.
So our God is Muslim. Yes. We haven't seen him. He's unseen.
Yes, I know that's the problem. Muslims haven't seen God. And nor do they know him. And they don't know God either. In Islam, God is unknowable.
Do you know God?
God is unknowable.
Do you know God?
God is unknowable. Yes, I do know God.
So we have two gods.
I do know God. The problem is Jesus Christ.
The problem is
I come to know God in the person of Jesus Christ. So let me try to interrupt me now. Because he can't deal with 14. So let's carry on. Because in St. John 17, that Lamin, yes, I am. In St. John 17,
right.
In St. John 17,
now engage.
Lamin's got some problems. Let's engage.
This good, you right.
Let's engage, Lamin.
Well.
So, Lamin, let's engage.
Engage.
So, Lamin, I want you to answer my question. Lamin's not good at questions, so we're going to have a problem here. Lamin, I want you to answer my question. I want you to answer my question, Lamin. Verse 3, I agree with you. It says, this is eternal life. I agree with you, Lamin, but I want you to answer me this. I agree with you that in 3, Jesus is saying that God is a true God. I'm agreeing with you. There's not a disagreement. But what you like to do is you stop there. So I want you to answer me this, Lamin. My question is this. Verse 5. And now, O Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. What does that mean? What is Jesus saying? How did he have glory with the Father before the world existed? What does it mean?
Which Father then?
I'm asking Lamin.
It's only fair. Come on, Lamin.
What does it mean, Lamin? What does St. John 17:5 mean? You know what St. John 3 means. I find it interesting. Yes.
I'm asking you.
Look. I'm asking you. See, he doesn't answer questions. Go ahead. He doesn't answer questions. I'm asking you.
Accuser of Muslims.
Lamin.
Answer the question.
Be fair, Lamin.
Lamin. Lamin.
Be fair.
What they said time and time again.
Please be fair. Answer his question.
Yes. I'm giving you the opportunity. Lamin. I'm giving you the opportunity, you're on camera, to show yourself intelligent. Show yourself intelligent and answer the question. You continue to want to be a scholar of the Dawah team, but you come up, you don't come up trumps. You fail to come up trumps. It's a simple question. He knows what verse 3 means, but he can't tell you what verse 5 looks like.
I find that very easy.
I'm listening.
Listen to me.
I'm giving him the opportunity and he's not answering. I'm answering.
You listen to me.
You're preaching at your camera. I want you to answer what the 17:5 means. What did Jesus mean? And now, our Father, glorify thou me with thine own self, with the glory which I had with thee before the world was. What does it mean?
What does it mean, Lamin? Fair question.
Listen to what I'm saying. Look, listen to me. The Muslims tell you the Bible is not 100% word of God. Listen to me. I'm finished talking. We believe any verse here that agrees with the Quran, we take it.
There you go. He's desperate. He has no answer.
Simple.
Here is the man that wants to be the scholar of the Dawah team, and he keeps failing to come up trumps.
Explain it.
Jesus said, now, O Father, glorify thy name with thy own self,
that is with him, Jesus himself, with the glory which I had with you before the world was.
So what does that mean?
For first of all, I'm asking you. Why don't you want to answer? And then when you get it wrong, I'll tell you.
Ask him to, because we are telling you.
And then when you get it wrong, I will tell you.
We the Muslims are telling you.
He doesn't know. Jesus is saying that he existed before the world was. He existed before the foundation of the world. Before the universe existed, Jesus existed. That's what it's saying. Before the universe existed, before the world existed, Jesus would be God.
Show us another prophet that said that.
Listen to
show us another prophet that said that. And I take my shahada right now.
Yeah, that's fine. And I will.
I take my shahada right now.
You have two converts. Levin, you have two converts. If you answer the question, see, he's not answering the question. If you don't know that, this is what Levin does.
So Jesus, so what? My next question.
So what does that mean? Tell me.
I just told you.
What does that mean?
Heard, it's on the camera. Don't worry. It's on the camera. The camera will.
What does that mean?
Now I'm asking you. What does it mean?
Zag, help me.
Admit that you don't know.
Zachariah, help me.
You don't know. Tell me.
Okay, right.
Tell me.
It's Jesus, right. Jesus is saying exactly what he says. I existed before the foundation of the world.
What does that mean?
Before the world, exactly what he says. Before the world existed, I existed. Before the world existed, I existed. That's what Jesus is saying. Before the world existed,
you hear me?
Before the world existed,
that means
he's
God
existed.
He can't answer it.
Well, okay. Okay, right. Now my question: if it doesn't mean he's God, what does it mean? If it doesn't mean that he's God, what does it mean?
Hold on.
If it doesn't mean that he is God, what does it mean?
Hold on.
If it doesn't mean that he is God, what does it mean?
If that verse says Jesus is God, listen to me, Otto, then you have read your Bible. You know why? When Jesus, according to the Bible, Lama Sabachthani, my God.
He's not answering the question. Once again, he does what he does best. He cannot answer one single question.
Listen to me.
Levin has been defeated by every Christian in his car. He's been defeated by every Christian in his car. He hasn't read the Bible. Can I borrow these, Levin? Can I borrow your Bible?
Levin, oh my God.
Levin, can I borrow your Bibles?
Levin,
can I borrow them? You haven't read those. You have not read them. You take them out, but you haven't read them. Answer my question. Right. So Lamin has been caught lying once again. Lamin, the Master Takia of Speaker's Corner. He's been caught lying. I asked him a simple question. Explain to me what St. John 17:5 means. Because he likes 17:3. He likes St. John 17:3, where Jesus said that there's only one true God. But he doesn't like 17:5. So once again, Muhammad's been caught lying. Muslims have no answers. They need to answer the question. The scriptures are clear. Jesus is God. Jesus is God in human form. Muhammad has been busted.
Perfect.
Once again. He has been busted once again. Note this guy. He's a liar. He has been busted. He's going to edit that video as well. He will edit that, but don't worry. He's going to edit that.
Ella Lama Sabatan.
He's going to edit that.
My God, don't worry.
You can see your witness.
Was God.
You have witnessed that he hasn't answered any question.
You
have declared to witness that you haven't answered any question.
He's contradicting.
God is dead. Once again, go. See the problem.